Hello students, welcome you all for the second class of laws of motion. What did we learn in the previous class? In the previous class we have learned about effects of forces. Nearly five effects of forces we have seen, and we have understood what we mean by force. Then the forces are divided into two kinds, which are contact and non-contact forces. About it we have learned it perfectly, and we have given number of examples also for contact forces and non-contact forces. So second part of your laws of motion is what I mean by Newton's first law of motion, or it is also called as law of inertia. So in today's quantum class, completely we will understand what you mean by Newton's first law of motion, or what you mean by law of inertia. Already we know that there are how many laws of Newton? There are three laws of Newton. So in this chapter, very briefly, we will study about Newton's first law. In the next video, we will study Newton's second law, then Newton's third law, and the last part of what we mean by gravitation. So without quickly wasting the time, let us come to today's topic, that is what you mean by Newton's first law of motion. See, Newton's first law of motion is also called as law of inertia. Remember this. Understand? Newton's first law of motion is also called as law of inertia. See, what do you mean by inertia and law? We will be studying in the later of the chapter. Before starting the Newton's first law of motion, we need to understand what Galileo's law of inertia. Who is this Galileo? Have you remember anything about Galileo? Or you might have studied in your some GK books. Who discovered telescope? It is Galileo. Galileo is a scientist who comes in 16th century, before Newton. Before Newton, the scientist was Galileo. He was not only a physicist, he had his achievement in all the field of science and even mathematics also. And what else you know about Galileo? Galileo discovered pendulum. Pendulum also has been discovered by Galileo. Then Galileo, what else he has been done? Galileo discovered natural satellites of planet Jupiter also. Many of the inventions are under Galileo. He is a very famous physicist also. So what Galileo's law of inertia? What did Galileo tell in the 16th century? Let us discuss now. The first one. If a body is at rest, you are understanding that. What is the example we can take? If a body is at rest, think that a textbook is there on your table. It is at rest. It remains at rest unless a force is applied on it. Obviously, this is correct. See, for example, consider there is a table. This is a table. Upon a table, I have kept a book. Think this is a book. Right. Come back to the statement. If a body is at rest, which is a body here, book is considered to be a body. Book is at rest. Right. Where is it? It is lying on the table. It is rest. It remains at rest unless the force is applied on it. Means, unless you pick that book, what will be the position of the book? The position of the book will be always lying on the table. Unless you apply a force and pick it up, it will remain there forever. Not even after 1 year, 2 years, or 100 years. If some force is not applied on the book, what happens to that book? If some force is not applied on the book, it remains there forever. Is it not true? Yes, it is very much true. Not only in the case of tables and books or some any example you take in the universe. If something which has been lying there, unless it is being external force is being applied on that, it remains always at that rest. So I hope this part we have understood. What is the Galileo's law of inertia? The first part is if a body is at rest, it remains at rest unless the force is applied on it. Unless the force is applied on it, it always remains at what? Restless. Then what did he tell in the second observation? Look at it. If a body is moving, now let us consider this was the example of the first one. For the second one, I consider here. Think that ball, which is keep on what? Which is keep on moving. Right? If a body is moving, here ball is considered to be the ball. It is moving. It will continue to move with the same speed in the same direction unless a force is applied on it. Obviously, right? For example, think that you are playing a football match. You have kicked the ball towards east. Towards the east, it will be moving in the same direction with the same speed, unless there is some other person who kicks the ball in the opposite direction. Right? Again, what happened? The force may change. You are understanding the topic. I hope you understand. See, in the first case, body will be at rest. Unless you apply a force on that, it remains at rest forever. Is it not true? Correct. What is the second assumption of Galileo? What he is saying is that if your body is not only at rest, if your body is in motion also, it will be in a motion with the same speed and same direction unless an external force acts upon it. Very much true. Now I need to tell you that one more example for this. Think, for example, ball. We all have seen. If you leave the ball on the floor, does it come to rest after some time or not? Yes. For example, think that the ball is moving on a rough surface. Ball is moving on a rough surface. If the ball is moving on a rough surface, what type of force is acting between the floor and the ball? We have studied in the case of contact force. That is called as what you mean by frictional force. What you mean by frictional force. Even this frictional force is an external force. See, if there was no frictional force between the ball and the surface, this ball would be keep on moving for 100 years, 1000 years. That is true. But why it is not able to move? If you leave the ball on the rough surface, it moves for about 10 to 20 meters and stop. Why is the reason? The reason is that there is some force which has been acting. That is external force which has been acting between the ball and the surface. What is that external force for us? In this case, it is frictional force. If this frictional force was not there, what was the situation of the ball? Ball will be keep on moving for 100 years also, 1000 years also. But that is not going to happen. The reason is that there is a frictional force. And one more thing, anything just, for example, simple pendulum you have seen in your lab, right? This is being a rigid surface. You just swing and leave. It will be keep on continuously swinging? No, it does not. What happens? This is true and true motion of a simple pendulum. Why does the simple pendulum come to rest? Because there is a frictional force which is happening from air. You understand? Everywhere the air is being present. Air itself is applying an external force. For example, more than simple pendulum, take a swing which you have in your playground. Push once and leave your friend. What happens? After some time, the swing comes to rest. Is it not? Why did swing come to rest? Because the air itself is acting as an external force. The air itself is acting as an external force. If there was an external force, hence the swing comes to rest. Think that there is no air at all. Consider the situation of vacuum. If you consider the situation of vacuum, always what happens? The swing will be keep on moving. Why? The swing will be keep on moving for 100 years, 1000 years. The reason is there was no external force. But did you understand? We cannot think of that situation of vacuum because if we want to leave, air is must. So if air is being present, it's like present in the external force on the body. So I hope you have understood about Galileo's laws of inertia. What it is? By these two things we have understood. That is, if object is at rest, it will be always at rest, unless an external force acts on it. If object is in motion, it will be always in motion, unless an external force acts upon it. These are the two laws which was given by Galileo at that point of time. Now, what did Newton did here? We are studying about Newton's first law. Then what is the part of the Newton? Newton, what he did? No, he observed these two laws of Galileo, what he has done, and put a law based on this observation. That law is called as what you mean by Newton's first law of motion. See, actually at first Newton didn't give his name, Newton's first law of motion. By looking into these observations made by Galileo, what did Newton? Newton put the law based on this observation. So later part of that, now it is known as what you mean by Newton's first law of motion. What you mean by Newton's will see first what is the statement. What is the statement of Newton's first law of motion? Then I will make you to understand what actually is Newton's first law of motion. First, let us take the statement. So, according to Newton's first law of motion, if a body
keep on moving. That is the to us. Whatever the humans do on the object is present to us. Right? So it is called as, it is the inherent property of each object. It is an inherent property. Understand? You are understanding? This is the concept of what you mean by inertia. Inertia means the object, if it is rest, it will be at rest mode. If it is in motion, it will be in motion mode. Until when? Until some external force acts upon it. That's all. That external force comes under the definition of force. You are understanding? So, this Newton's first law, look at it. From here to, if your body is in a state of rest, it remains in a state of rest. If it is in a state of motion, it remains in the same direction with the, for example, it remains in motion. It remains in motion with the same direction and the same speed. Till here, it comes under the definition of inertia. Newton's first law is divided into two parts. Which are the two parts? That is definition of inertia and definition of force. Until where the definition of inertia is, definition of inertia will be till here. So, what do you mean by inertia? That is, if your body is in a state of rest, it remains in the state of rest. If your body is in a state of motion, it remains in the state of motion in the same direction with same speed. This is called as what you mean by inertia. Understand? Means it is a property of an object. If your body is in rest, it will be at rest mode. If your body is in motion, it will be in motion mode. Unless when it comes under what you mean by definition of force, which we will see now. See, for example, a book lying on a tabletop will remain placed at its place unless it is displaced, obviously. Right? You all know that. You will not have to study for your test until the test comes. There is some book which you bought from library. Go keep it in your room. It will be there forever. Means what? Until the library teacher asks, you won't bring it back. Means unless you touch it, it has remained in the same place. That's better example you can take. The book lying on a tabletop. A book which is lying on a tabletop will remain placed at its place unless it is displaced. This is the example we can take for inertia. One more example also you can take, that the ball is keep on rolling on a horizontal thing. That see, this is what is a horizontal plane. You have studied in mathematics. Right? This is horizontal, this is vertical. Think of ball which is keep on moving. Inertia, that is, if your body is in a state of motion, it remains in a state of motion itself. This comes under what? This comes under what you mean by definition of inertia. Inertia means it's a property of object. Object has that property. If you keep it somewhere, it will be there forever. If you keep the ball moving, it will keep on moving. Understand? This comes under until when, where this ball will be in motion. Unless an external force, that is force of friction. What will make the ball force of friction? By the force of friction, this ball will move, for example, 120 meter and stops. Here, what made the ball to stop? The ball to stop by what you mean by force. That force part we will study now. I hope you have been understanding. See, Newton's first law, that is the statement. I am keeping the statement there itself to explain you this properties. That is, Newton's first law is divided into two parts. Which are the two parts? Definition of inertia. Just now we have understood the definition of inertia. Now we will move on and explain what we mean by definition of force. The second part, how we understand the Newton's first law of motion, depends on definition of force. So what actually the definition of force? Force is that external cause which tends to change the state of rest or the motion of the body. This is the only force which can change. See, if your body is in state of rest or a state of motion, that is comes under inertia. So how can you change that inertia? Inertia can be changed by applying an external unbalancing force. Right, understand? So from here to here, it is under the definition of inertia. From here to here, it is definition of force. So Newton's first law is a combination of definition of inertia and definition of force. Understand? See, this is what a very simple thing. So only by force of input, we can make the body to change motion to rest or rest to motion. That we have studied in the case of effects of force. The same thing we are trying here. First, the book lying on a table gets displaced from its place when it is pushed. For example, you think book is lying on a table. If a book is keep on lying on a table, it comes under the definition of inertia. But when does it change? When you apply a force, when you push the book, what happens? The book may fall down. If it's a paper, the book may fall down. So how did it fall down? It fall down by applying a force. Right? By applying a force, we have changed the position of a book from table top to book. Understand? So what is the second? It is not only in the case of rest to motion. It can be in a motion to rest also. That is, a moving bicycle stops when a retarded force is applied by the brakes. Obviously, bicycle will be in motion. Suddenly, some dog comes in front of it. What you people will do? We will apply brake. Brake in a sense, we will make the motion of a bicycle to come to rest. How did it happen? It happened by what we mean by retarded force. So, retarded force means you know already, it's the opposite force. It is applied by the brakes. Applied by the brakes on the wheels. So here also by applying a force, we made that object which was in motion to come to rest. See, overall, what do you mean by Newton's first law of motion? If your body is in state of rest, it will be in state of rest only. If your body is moving, it will be keep on moving only. Until when? That's the question. Until when in the sense? Until an external force is being acting on it. If an external force acts on it, what happens? If something is rest, we can make it into motion. If something is in motion, we can make it into rest. For the better example is book on a table, which was at rest before. We made it into motion. Now motion by applying a force. Right. Next, bicycle. Bicycle was in motion. We made it to stop, come to rest by applying brakes. So by the force, we can make both from motion to rest, rest to motion. Understand? Before applying a force, still here. That a body may be in a motion only or it will be in a rest only. That concept is called as what we mean by inertia. Inertia is a subjective property of what? Subjective property or inherent property of an object. Understand? So next we have some note which is dependent on what you mean by force. Then we will proceed to what you mean by mass and inertia. How mass and inertia is related with two examples. Then we will go on. There is a types of inertia what we need to learn. There is a type of inertia even that we will study now. Now we have few notes which we need to know about the force. It is very important also. First one, force is a vector. This we know. Force, how it is a vector point? Force has both magnitude and direction. So always remember, force is a vector point. So how do we denote the force? F with an arrow cap, because we have studied in motion in one dimension that how to represent a vector is by arrow cap of this. See, the next one is, this is not there in your textbook, but you should know this much structure. Understand? What do you mean by balanced force and what do you mean by unbalanced force? So, what do you mean by balanced force is the two equal forces acting in opposite direction on an object. To make you to understand it better, see, I have considered a tug of war game. This is a war of tug of war. Your universe in this game. Think that two members from each side is in play. You both are in 80 kg. Even that said, the members who are there also is an 80 kg. So when you both are in the same weight, if you start pulling it equally, see, you will be pulling it in this direction, they will be pulling the in the direction, right? They both are opposite to each other. But still this position A does not move anywhere. It will be remaining here itself. Why is the reason? The reason is two opposite forces what you are acting on it is equal. That is, the force what is being applied here is equal in magnitude. Force is in equal magnitude. Equal magnitude. So what happens? This position of A never changes, is it not? See, the two equal forces acting on an opposite direction. So this is an example for we mean by balancing force. But remember, according to Newton's first law, a balancing force cannot mean the change of state of rest to motion or motion to rest. There should be which force? I have written. There should be, unless and until, an external unbalanced force. If there is unbalanced force only, it can cause what you mean by Newton's first law of motion. Then we can see what you mean by unbalanced force. It's just an opposite form of balance. The two forces acting in opposite direction, always it will be acting in opposite direction, on a body of not equal magnitude. Of not equal magnitude. See, the same type of game I have taken. Here it is 60 Newton, here it is 80 Newton. Obviously, who wins? Obviously, the side B is. Consider this A side and B side. Obviously, the B side, look at the A, it has moved almost towards them. Means they had won the game. How did they won the game? Because the force which is being applied by them is more. And it is it balanced? No. It is not balanced, it is unbalanced. When an unbalanced force itself acts on an object, it can change its rest to motion, motion to rest. That is why I am explaining you what you mean by balanced force and unbalanced force. So in your definition in the textbook, they have not given unbalanced force. But you add it because it makes a correct meaning in a proper way. Now, the next concept what we have is mass and inertia. How the mass and inertia is being related? So what do you actually know by mass? Mass is that what we are comprises of. Weight is nothing but, look at here, there is a difference between weight is nothing but mass into gravity. This is called weight. Understand? Means if your weight changes if you go from place to place, but your mass never changes. You have to remember this very well. So what it is? The property of inertia is because of the mass of the body. Whatever the property of inertia is, inertia property is always because of the what? Mass of the body itself. Now, for example, we take a table. Upon a table, I have kept a piece of paper. One piece of paper. This is the first example. Same on that, I have kept in another table B. This is table A. Here I have a book. Right. So, the property of inertia is because of the mass of the body. Here is a paper. We are willing to apply a lot of force on paper or about book. Obviously, we need to apply more force on book to displace it rather than a paper. Why? Because inertia, the property of inertia is because of the mass of the body. It depends on what? Mass of the body. Even for the second one, we see the same. Look at it. Lighter body has less inertia than the heavier body. Is it not? For example, you can take a small stone and a big rock. Now, we need to apply a less force. For example, 10 Newton of force is enough to take a stone and throw. But if we have to push the rock, how much we need? We need nearly 50 Newton. 50 Newton of force. That is what they are explaining. Lighter body has less inertia. Right? Its inertia is very less. It can easily apply it by a less force and do that. Then the heavier body is like big rocks. It has more inertia. What type of inertia? Inertia rest. For example, if a road roller is coming, that is inertia of motion. It has greater inertia of motion than a bicycle. Understand? This is what the difference. Mass is a measure of inertia. This is a very important third note. See, mass is a measure of what? Mass is a measure of inertia. I hope you have understood the mass and inertia relationship. What are they? First, the property of inertia is because of what? Mass of the body. You can take this example. Then, lighter body has less inertia than the heavier body. Then, mass is a measure of inertia. I hope you have understood this. Next, now we are going to know what we mean by types of inertia. Inertia of rest and inertia of motion. In two examples we will see and wind up today's first Newton's first law of motion lesson. Now we have the last part of Newton's first law of motion, that is kinds of inertia. So what are the kinds of inertia? Inertia of rest and inertia of motion. See, this is not a known part data. We already know inertia is either point if it is object will be at rest or object will be in motion. That is the kinds of inertia, that is inertia of rest and inertia of motion. So we will define what is inertia of rest with one example and inertia of motion with one example. In your textbook, they have given 5 to 6 examples for both inertia of rest and inertia of motion. In that, anyone you can try in your own home. So please try those and send me the video in my WhatsApp.
So let us see what you mean by inertia of rest.
If your body is at rest, it will remain at rest unless an external force is applied to change its state of rest. We have seen any example, book, paper, any example. You know that is what it is, property of an object, inherent property of an object. If your object is at rest, it will be there at rest only. Why? Unless an external force acts upon it. So that comes under what you mean by inertia of rest. What is inertia of rest? A body continues to be at rest itself until an external force acts upon it. That condition is called what you mean by inertia of rest. To explain you inertia of rest very much, let me take one example. So this example you can try in your own. You all have to try it and send me the video of that. Take a tumbler. A tumbler means which you drink a coffee or anything that we have a tumbler. Make one card by using a pad of a book or something. Just a card of bit thick. Okay? That should be more than that of a card. Tumbler. For example, the tumbler size is this much. If a tumbler size is this much, you can make a card of this length. Okay? Upon that card, place a coin. Above that card, place a coin. You are understanding some 5 rupee coin or something, so it will be of no thickness and visible. What you do is that, hold this or keep it on a table. Keep this tumbler on a table or something. See, there should be a tumbler. Above the tumbler, there should be a card. Above the card, there should be a coin. From your finger, you can see in your textbook also, they have given this out. From your finger, next come you play a carrot or lighter, just push the card. When you apply a force and push the card, what happens is that card moves front, but the coin which was above that, does it move? No. That coin will fall into the tumbler. By this, what we are understanding, see, this is a very good example to understand the inertia of rest. You apply a force on only the card. You need to apply a force on coin, is it not? Yes. Means when you apply a force on a card, only that moves. On a coin, we didn't apply any force. So the coin is still in the case of rest. Means if the body is at rest, it remains at rest. No? Coin was at rest. After applying a force on card also, coin is there. Coin is in the position of rest itself. Why? Because there is no external force acted upon it. Then what is the external force you operate on a card? External force you operate only on card. So card had moved from here to here. But the coin which was above the card, which is comes back to that tumbler, comes to fall inside that tumbler. This is a very best example to understand the inertia of rest. So by this what we understood, to which we apply external force, only that moves. For example, here we apply the external force to the card, that moves it. But what about the coin? We didn't apply the external force. So it had fallen into the same tumbler. So this you please perform in your home. It's very tricky also. You will enjoy it. Literally you will enjoy it. Next I have what we mean by inertia of motion. What is the inertia of motion? A body is that keeps on continuing in motion unless an external force acts upon it. See, a body is in motion, continues to be in state of motion with the same speed, same direction, in a straight line, unless an external force is applied on that. To explain to that, I have taken an example. When the running bus stops, suddenly the passenger tends to lean forward, is it not? You may be sitting in a seat or you may be standing in a bus. You very often, every day you will feel this in your going in school bus from your home to school. Suddenly if a driver applies the brake, how do you lean? You lean forward. Why so? Because in your park, for example, when you consider this portion of your legs or your body will be in motion along with bus. Will be in motion along with bus, not literally the upper part. This upper part will not be so much in motion. Suddenly, when a bus stops, what happens? This part, which was already in motion, comes to rest. Suddenly, it comes to rest. But what about your upper part? your upper part won't come to rest so suddenly. So suddenly you will be forward. Understand? So this is also, I will be sharing one video along with this chapter. So watch that video of all activities which has been shown. By that you will understand this Newton's first law of motion or law of inertia very clearly. If any sort of doubts you have, be free enough to ask. In the next video, we are going to study about what you mean by Newton's second law of motion and linear momentum. That is a very big thing what we need to study. And this is what you mean by Newton's first law of motion or law of inertia. I hope you have understood this. Until then, next.